Time pushes the reset button, and I think that's maybe what he did with me. You think, oh, I'm close to the Lord, and I got my eyes on him. But I just say this, I don't know how close you are to God this morning, but you can get closer.
Yeah.
And you know what he wants to do? He wants to get closer to you, draw nigh to God, and he will draw nigh to you.
Yep.
You know the question really is, how close do you want to get? Not a matter of how close God wants to get to us. Can I tell you this? Oh my goodness, he wants to get so close that there's nothing else more important in your life than him. And that's what this verse is saying to me. You know, because this sickness, I thought those first couple of days, I didn't know. I thought, I was thinking about dying. I was thinking about leaving Melissa and my family and all of y'all. And I mean, it was going through my mind. I thought, I can't do nothing but live or die. And that's really all you can do when you're in that spot. But here's the verse. I'll be honest with you, when you're that sick, you can't read a whole lot. You want to, but you can't. I turn the phone on and let it like read to me. You know, like my Bible app, technology. But right here in verse 4, he said, when Jesus heard that, he said, this sickness is not unto death. All right? Now that's part of it. Do you think, man, just rejoice in that. When the Lord gave me peace on that and just assured me of that, then I didn't know how sick I was going to get or how long it was going to be, but I knew I'd get better. I mean, I'm recovering, but I'm not, I'm getting better, but I'm certainly not where I want to be. But I know this sickness is not unto death. And I can shout the victory and we can say, praise God. Man, the preacher, look what God did for the preacher. Look what God, but you understand this sickness was not unto death, but it wasn't about the preacher.
Right.
Y'all understand that? This wasn't about your preacher. I want you to love the preacher, and I know you do. I want you to love my God more than you love me. I want you to love this church. We love our church. But I want you to love this. I want you to love God, the God of the church, more than you love the church. Love the God of the preacher more than you love the preacher. And you see, when you do that, look what the Lord said. He said, the sickness is not unto death, but for the glory of God. That's what it was for. And he's still.
Yep.
I'm recovering right now, but it's for the glory of God. If I'd have died in that hospital, then that would have been for the glory of God. But God let me live. And you know, we say, well, I don't know why he let me live. Yeah, I read it right here. It's for the glory of God.
Amen.
And whatever God's doing in your life, and I tell you something, if you'll let him, it's for the glory of God. You and your family, whatever God does with your family, it ought to be for the glory of God. What we do at Heritage Baptist Church, and I tell you what, I'm going to major on that when I'm able. I'm going to major on it. But it's for the glory of God. And then I love this. It's not just that. God gets glorified, but notice he specified this then. Look at this. This sickness is not unto death, but for the glory of God, and that the Son of God might be glorified thereby. Now think about that. That the Son of God might be glorified thereby. That means the Lord, our God, and his Son, Jesus Christ, are going to get the glory. And they can get the glory.
Yeah.
And here's what it is. So then I realize, all right, this sickness is not about me. It's about him. I realize the church is not about the church. It's about the Lord and how we glorify God. And I want us to be a church that glorifies the Lord. I want to be a pastor that glorifies the Lord and the Lord Jesus and his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. And I want them to get the glory out of everything we do. That's why you read your Bible, that's why living a sinful life won't give glory to God. That's why living a carnal life won't give glory to God. That's why living a selfish life won't give glory to God. But living a sacrificial life and living a life that's just about Jesus. He is worthy. He is worthy. I was going to have you just turn over and tell y'all I got a message from the angels and see what y'all thought about that. Amen. They're going like, preacher's going crazy, man. Angels flying around in his bedroom, giving him something out of the Bible. No, I'm talking about out of the Bible. Open Revelation chapter 5. It says, when they had taken the book, the four beasts and the four elders fell down before the Lamb. That's chapter 5. Verse 11, and I heard the voice of many angels round about the throne, and the beast and the elders, and the numbers there were 10,000 times 10,000s and thousands of thousands. You know what that is? A bunch.
Right. Yep.
What are they all saying? What are they all giving glory to? What's it about? Who's it about? Saying with a loud voice, worthy is the Lamb that was slain. Here's what he's going to receive. Receive power and riches and wisdom and strength and honor and glory.